Wave program for March 2020. The program has been edited to fit the time available. Carriers for Lone Star State.
From Hollywood, it's time now for Bob Bailey as...
Johnny Dollar.
Sure, he took off the $75,000 about 6 months ago.
Right.
Nothing, Paul.
Nothing.
Well, when the
funny. The only girl in blue suit. Hello, Mr. Wilson.
Thanks.
See, yes, I'm jumpy.
I'm in a good business for you. Tell me, did you ever hear the name Summers?
Summers? Well, in Santo Tomas, is always Summers.
Okay. I mean a man named Summers. Alvin Summers. Here's his picture. Take a look.
Like that up to you too. Not out on the terrace.
The terrace is
wailing and howling to breathe. She gets me to sleep soon.
I'll put the notes on the fire, don't mind.
Yeah.
You must be down here to see how the other half.
You mean to see if anybody lives in this town? I'm talking from a great spot for vacation.
Pretty dull.
Real. Easy. Yes, sir.
Johnny Dollar.
From
Hollywood, it's time now for Bob Bailey as...
Johnny Dollar.
Oh, how are you? I'm so baby. I've already had a date.
What?
Remember the big gorilla at the corner table downstairs in the cantina? The one who's staring at us?
Sure. What about
him? Well, he was waiting for me in my room just now. He didn't like the way I parted my hair. I guess he changed it. With a gun barrel.
Honey, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm sorry for a month or two, sure.
Sounds to me like you need a little nursing, Johnny.
I always do.
Tonight and every weekday night, Bob Bailey and the transcribed adventures of the man with the action-packed expense account, America's fabulous freelance insurance investigator, yours truly, Johnny Dollar.
Account submitted by Special Investigator Johnny Dollar to the Home Office, Northeastern Fidelity, in Bonneville, Western Connecticut. The following is an account of additional expenses during my investigation of the Alvin Summers and Besselman case. Item 4, three numbers American to Eduardo Moreno, M.D., the doctor who cost me assorted lumps and bruises I collected from a strong man who seemed quite convinced that I should leave town. For a moment, I figured he could be the man who was to contact me with information as to the whereabouts of Alvin Summers, the embezzler. As it turned out, all he wanted to say to me was goodbye, and he said it very convincingly. But Gloria was waiting for me. She definitely seemed to want to get better acquainted, and although I didn't know what her angle was, I figured it might be fun finding out. I left the joint where I was staying and went up to the Playa del Mar, the big expensive hotel over there in the city. There was a terrace with some tables and a flamenco singer waiting at the moment. Gloria was at one of the tables. Hi.
Danny, what the world happened to you? Can I talk to you over the phone?
I'm sorry I'm late, Gloria. You can see by my face I ran into kind of a rough detour.
You all right now?
Yeah.
Johnny, you said it was that man who kept staring at us in the bar over there?
That's the one. Real charming fellow. Muscles, too.
What happened?
I went to my room to change before coming up here. He was waiting for me, working over. The general idea was I should leave Santa Tomas in a hurry.
But why?
I don't know. Yet. But somewhere along the line, I'll make a point to find out. Yeah?
Oh, Johnny, where are you? Well, it's like things are picking up a little.
How so?
I told you I found this place pretty dull. But now, with you getting more action, so to get out of town, it's beginning to sound a little more interesting.
Well, I could do with more dullness and a few less bruises, believe me.
You must be down here on a lot more than just a vacation, Johnny.
Oh, I don't know. A lot of people apparently come down here to this town just for vacation. That's how you told me you're looking here, remember?
There's only one difference.
What's that?
I really am on a vacation, and I don't think you are.
Mm-hmm.
You're not the top of the mountain.
Why?
Most of our city, maybe. Well, anyway. But not far from us. No, I think I'm going down here to meet somebody. Or find somebody.
Okay. Suppose I do. Where would I be looking?
If you don't know, how would I?
Looking for you, honey.
Now, that's the nicest thing you've said to me all day. If you are, too bad I didn't know it soon.
Why?
It would have made this time a little more bearable. Waiting.
Maybe you've been looking for me.
Well,
that's
not least one. Well, I thought I was being so subtle.
You have been looking for me?
Well, I must admit, I've been looking for someone who's alive in this town. Of course, what I should say is that I've always been looking for you.
Okay. I guess that leaves me right where I started.
Huh?
Skip it. So, we're just two happy people on vacation.
Yeah. Okay,
Tommy.
Okay.
Hey, look, music. That's the flamenco singer you were telling me about?
Mm-hmm. Sounds pretty weird, doesn't it? I don't like it. Do you like it?
Mm-hmm.
Sounds even weirder from down below on the beach. Like to see for yourself?
Yeah. Yeah, I think I'd like to.
Mm-hmm. Give me a minute.
What's that?
I think people staring at you.
That giant thing? Where is it?
It's a little man over at the end of the terrace, see?
Oh, that's the leader.
Who?
The bellboy at my hotel. Excuse me, ma'am. Be right back.
Sure.
Senor Dollar.
Hi, everybody.
We hope to see you come up here.
What's on your mind?
Not only you pay me money to go get some information for you.
That's right. I want to know if anybody's been trying to contact me. You turn up anything?
Not at all, that's true, but the picture you showed.
The one of Alvin Summers?
See, I thought I seen him in Santo Tomas. Now I'm sure of good work. Tonight I talked to a friend of mine. I described Senor Summers to him. He told me he used to work for him as a houseboy clerk.
Did he tell you where Summers is now?
No, he could not tell me that. Couldn't?
Or what?
I do not know, sir, but to tell me where the house is, you could not find it, sir. It's in from the boots in the jungle anyway. I will have to take the way.
Let's go.
No, no, I'm supposed to be on duty by the hotel. I must get down there once before the hotel seems to have gone.
When you get out of
here? I'll move, mate. I'll come to your room then and take you to the Thomas house.
Okay.
Thank you.
stooge with a machine.
Steve, looking for you?
Turn around behind the lodge here, then back up the path to the hotel.
No.
Why
don't
you follow me?
I'm not going to see. They can't help you, Michelle.
Well, sooner or later, I got a little matter to settle with that big ape. I might as well be sure.
No, Chief. I just want you to get hurt again, Jimmy. I'm not going to leave you.
Okay, come on. Let's shift around to the other side of this rock, Mr.
Tonight and every weekday night,
transcribed adventures of the man with the Action Tax Expense Account. Tomorrow's with fabulous freelance insurance investigator, yours truly, Johnny Dollar.
Santa Tomas, Mexico. Expense account submitted by Special Investigator Johnny Dollar.
To the Home Office, Northeastern Fidelity and Bonding, Brooklyn, Connecticut.
The following is an account of additional expenses during my investigation of the Alvin Summers $75,000 embezzlement case. Item 6, $25 American. Funeral and burial expenses for Benita LaBelle. Somebody had to do it, and he apparently had no family. After I made the arrangements for the town's undertaker, I went back to my room and received Lieutenant Gomez's polite but firm invitation to drop in. So I went on down to police headquarters.
See that? See you, man.
Thank you, man. So?
So, the has confirmed the fact that Benita still held out from knife wounds.
I didn't need an autopsy to tell me that. It was obvious.
But what is not obvious is your point of view on
the
case.
Look, the story hasn't changed a bit since I told it to you, Sergeant Romero. I went back to my room at midnight. I opened my balcony door and here old Benito.
His throat.
So that
is the story as to what is behind the story.
Let me well be aware.
For instance? For instance, in a case of relief, everyone is a potential suspect. Everyone. Including you.
Isn't this being pretty ridiculous, Gomez?
Is it? Then could you spoil the kindness to tell me if there was some legitimate reason you could have this truth got in your good way?
Well, in the first place, if you're interested in alibis, I've got...
Indeed?
Indeed. I was with a girl, Gloria Harris, up at the Hotel Plaza del Mar, all the...
Check. Well, you're not quite thinking of that. Checking on all your activities this evening.
In the second place, if you're interested in motives, I don't have one.
No.
Why would I want to kill Benito when I was hoping to get some information?
Information of what sort from the government?
Oh, I guess I better start at the top. What
kind of is my card? You're an insurance investigator.
That's right. About 6 months ago, a man named Alvin Summers out of the States embezzled $75,000 from the company he worked for. The outfit I'm representing was no wrote the bond on him, so they were stuck with him.
$75,000.
A couple of days ago, they got a long-distance phone call from down here in Santa Tomas. The man who called claimed to be an information about Alvin Summers. That's why I came down.
And who is the man who telephoned?
We don't know. I came on the chance that he might contact me here. Or that I might get some kind of lead on Alvin Summers' whereabouts.
That's of you?
No, I'm both counts. Benito said he knew about a place where Summers used to live. They were going to take me there tonight. But apparently somebody had other ideas.
A knife to back him up. Nobody has tried to contact you.
Oh, sure. Several people have.
Now he's from the world of women.
First, there was a man named Carson, a super salesman.
He tried to contact me for the purpose of setting up a cribbage game.
Cribbage?
Well, what is this cribbage?
Well, that's something I'm hoping to find out. Then there was a strong arm who bounced me around with a gun at all and suggested politely that I wanted to leave town.
Oh? Well, what did he look like?
He was heavy in the shoulders, thick neck, low forehead, short dark hair, and a scar over the bridge of his nose.
Scar? That would be some scouts.
You know him?
I know him by chance.
Oh, that's his pitch.
That is something I do look for. You see, if you must understand that Santa Tomas is a rather strange town, and a dangerous one. Come in.
Hello, thank you.
Can't you see that I'm busy, Sergeant Romero?
A very sad, Senor Donald.
Then, what is it?
Well, I can talk to Senorita Gloria Harris at the Hotel Playa del Mar. She said that Senor Vera was with her throughout the evening.
Very well.
One thing more. We have just arrested a man, an American tourist. The same person.
I will talk to him when I have time.
Yeah, well,
that's a super salesman.
He did?
Yeah.
Well, maybe he ties into this deal after all. What's the charge?
The mail?
Yeah. He's a disturbing the peace.
Oh, great. I thought I'd hold him. What's the matter? You got a keep so many under his belt, maybe?
Wait a moment. Here's the report.
See, of course, he's a
well, I should have left him with Viola. I will talk to the
doctor.
If you are honest, man, perhaps you had better talk.
Okay.
Dollar! Say, I'm sure.
much as they made a dollar. The dollar goes out.
I'm surprised he...
Well, what do you
know? He steps a little too far.
Well, I was only having a little fun.
So you just in these reports states that you're at the Hotel Playa del Mar this evening.
I see.
But now, Lieutenant Holmes states that you became increasingly noisy and that at one point during a dance by an entertainer, you grabbed this raptor from one of the musicians and attempted to join the dance.
Now, Lieutenant, maybe I was a little out of line, but I was
there. But when the dancer refused to dance with you, you chanced to never lift up your shell.
Trying to sell her a zipper, maybe?
Oh, no, dollar. Well,
finally, when the musician attempted to help his head up here away from you, you broke your guitar over his head.
Say, hey, when you get gone, you're a real tiger, aren't you?
Well, this seems true, Professor.
Well, I suppose the facts are correct, but they sound different somehow down here. I was just trying to have a little fun, you know.
See, Sergeant Romero will conduct you to the magistrate.
Romero? A dollar? You're just going to stand there and not do anything? We both live at the same hotel, and... Oh, you're a big help.
What'll happen to him?
You will have to pay the damages, and there will be a fine.
What's your probably going as expensive, huh?
Lieutenant, you started to tell me about this Peterborough Krauss.
What if you're dancing?
I was started to say that the final tickets from Mexico City built a new hotel. This town, unfortunately, used to be something of a haven for undesirable characters from the United States.
Which of these, huh?
Some of them still are in. And although I know very little about Senor Krause, it is probable that he is one of them.
Could be.
You said that he and Senor Krause are the only ones who have made any effort to contact him.
Yeah.
Except for Gloria Harrison, of course.
I still haven't found out what's on her mind.
Hmm?
I mean, what else? She's not here on a vacation, you believe?
In that case, it has certainly been a long vacation. She's been here for several months, to my knowledge.
Well, well. Now, that's very interesting, Lieutenant. Thanks. Anything else you want to ask me about Benito?
We don't have a moment, but I suggest you remain available.
You know where to find me.
One moment, Senor Dola.
Huh?
I'm very told you, this town can be a dangerous place.
I want to suggest that you'll be quite careful.
Yeah. And one thing I wish to impress upon you. If you are at any time tempted during your investigation to take the law into your own hands, I assure you that you will regret it.
Well, in that case, I hope you're around.
Oh, yeah. If
I need
you. Whether or not I am available, the warning stands by.
Okay.
Listen.
Okay.
Johnny.
Wow, Gloria. I thought you were
talking. I couldn't sleep, so I called your
hotel.
Oh? I phoned to the bellboy if you needed. Did you
make the police station so I came down here? Did you... anything you could have done? Not for Benito,
Arthur. He was killed in your room.
Yeah.
Do
you think you could have been killed by mistake?
Mistake? You mean maybe I was supposed to be the target? Yeah, that's what Johnny, I am troubled, Senator. You should tell me what it is. You're not just
going
on a vacation.
Speaking of vacations, Gloria.
Johnny,
what is it? She's looking straight ahead. Somebody crossed the street in the shadows and stairs.
Can you see
him? When he goes past that light, I'll be. Gloria, my old friend Krause again.
Oh, the man who came to your room and was about to go on the beach?
That's the boy. Funny how he always seems to pop up when I'm with you.
Johnny, I tell you, I don't know him.
What's the matter right now? Come on. Turn into the alley. Okay. Now keep going straight down this alley and out the other end. Go back to your hotel and I'll call you there later. Maybe a while.
What are you going to do?
Wait for me.
Hello, John.
Don't worry. Don't give me any idea this time. Get going. After she was out of sight, I ducked into a doorway. I wait.
Sweetheart?
How do you think about me, Krause? My only gun is working over me with a gun barrel.
Never!
All right. Now you're going to tell me what this is all about. Why you've been failing me. Why you worked me over with a gun barrel in my room last night? I want to hear all about it.
No, I just
talk.
You know, you came down here asking, but I ain't coming back.
What are you talking about?
You know, I've had this for 3 times.
3 times?
And you make me carry it.
Wait a minute. You ever hear of a man named Alvin Service?
Who?
I'm a Gloria Harris.
Sure.
You sure about that cross?
No.
Listen.
The truth.
Maybe you are. You're too punchy right now. Your routine. Yeah, I think I got it. You're wanted in the States. You figured I was a cop and came down here to make a pinch. No, there right now. I sure wish I was.
No, I'm no cop.
You sure did, Buster. Oh, no, no, not at all. I just love the feel of a gun barrel coming across my face. Cross, I got a nice little piece of advice for you. Next time, you better find out what the score is before you jump into the ball game. Just as I was about to open the door to my room, I heard someone go down inside. Went quietly down to the end of the hall, out the window, then eased along the balcony down toward my room. Inside, it was dark. I could make out someone bent over my leg, searching. I edged across the room, slowly. Then I lunged. Hello, Gloria.
Johnny.
Well, Johnny. Helping me unpack.
Look, Dang, Johnny.
You know something? That's just exactly what you're going to do.
There'll be another exciting episode in our story of the Alvin Summers matter tomorrow.
Tomorrow night, how to fall into a trap.
In 1 week, with us.
Jonas, won't you?
Just really, Johnny Dollar. Yours truly, Johnny Dollar, starring Bob Bailey, is transcribed in Hollywood.
Written by Robert Wright.
It is produced and directed by Jack Gemstone. Be sure to join us tomorrow night, same time and station, for the next exciting episode of Yours Truly, Johnny Dollar. Roy Rowan speaking.
Mayday. You're listening to a special broadcast of Old Time Radio from Texas Radio Shortwave, broadcasting to you from South Carolina, Texas. Please send your detailed nutritional reports to Texas Radio SW@gmail.com. That's Texas Radio SW@gmail.com. We'll reward you with something more precious than a chance of gold, a Texas Radio Shortwave cell.
From Hollywood, it's time now for Bob Bailey as...
Johnny Dollar.
Yeah, remember. I'm the guy you were making a big pitch for. Can't sing the whole line on the beach, the complete routine. Oh, I gotta hand it to you, baby. It was real nice.
No. Pardon that thing, Johnny. I meant it, all of it.
Oh, sure, buddy, sure. That's why I kept you here and searching my room. That's all part of the big romance.
Oh,
this is what you're gonna do. Hey, look, Gloria, one guy has already wound up dead on this deal. I've got a strong hunch I'm number 2 man on the list. And this baby I do not want.
Transcribed adventures of the man with the action, Patrick Pentagon, America's fabulous freelance insurance investigator, goes to Johnny Dollar.
Santo Tomas, Mexico, expense account submitted by special investigator Johnny Dollar to the Home Office, Northeastern Fidelity and Bonding, Hartford, Connecticut. The following is an account of additional expenses during my investigation of the Alvin Summers investment of $75,000. Item 9, $17.60, business entertainment for one Gloria Harris. Believe it or not, I wasn't going to put that item on the account because I figured it might just possibly be a private romance. But when I caught Gloria searching my hotel room, I knew she tied into the deal somehow. This will give me information on Summers' whereabouts.
Johnny, please.
Oh, you're not leaving, Gloria, not yet.
I'm just trying to get away.
Did you step up the ante?
Why should I? You lied.
I lied to you once. Only once. When I told you I'm here on vacation. I'm not.
Down here.
Really?
Oh, sure. That's why you're staying at the Playa Del Mar, the most expensive hotel in town.
I don't need no money. I'm not no faster. It's true. You can figure out a chance. Yeah. I've been stuck in this lot of town for 4 months. I'm hoping every day that figure out some way. Find somebody to help me get back to the state.
How can you fix this? The city,
I believe. Because I heard the fugitives from the state sometimes came here. I've been drifting around for a year from place to place. I guess I thought my luck would change.
How'd you lose your passport in the first place?
I'll tell you if you really want to know. Personally, I'd rather skip it. Long story, not a very pretty one. It's all in the past. It's just the way I made a mistake about a guy.
Okay, Gloria, okay. But there's one little item you haven't told me why you were searching my room just now.
Because I was trying to find out something about you, Johnny. The reason why you're down here.
Why?
Maybe I could make a deal with you.
Deal?
You help me in the past. And I'll help you.
Who can you help me?
You're looking for Alvin Summers, aren't you?
Am I?
6 months ago, he and I owed $75,000 at the safe with a boss.
Go on.
He came down here to find you. You're an insurance investigator.
Keep talking.
Okay.
Now maybe you wouldn't mind telling me how you know all this. Oh, sure. That report in my suitcase.
Alvin Summers, I know. I can help you, Johnny.
Where is it?
I don't know if you'll help me.
The passport?
The passport.
Well, what do you expect me to do about that?
Your business, John. You must meet a lot of people, all kinds. Maybe one of them has an extra passport or two for a private room.
All right, I'll
do it. That's
the best. Take it or leave it.
I'll take it better than your choice.
Now, about Alvin Summers?
I'll take you there. To Summers Street.
Where is it?
Down the beach, about a mile from the town. Then into the jungle over there.
How come you know where it is?
I met Alvin Summers a couple of weeks ago.
Here in San Antonio?
Yeah. Went there once for dinner.
Okay, you take me there, Gloria.
I better go up to the hotel and change. Something's pretty well from clothes.
Okay, I'll meet you at your hotel in half an hour.
Johnny, I only lied to you about one thing. The reason I was down here. The rest of it I am.
What is it, Lieutenant?
I just saw one of my men prancing your scrouse in the alley.
How is he seated?
They have been badly beaten.
They would not tell us anything, but it was very obvious who had done this to you.
So?
So, the last time we talked, Senor Dollar, I warned you not to attempt to take the law into your own hands.
Now listen, Gomez, if you think I'm going to take a pistol looking like he gave me and not do anything about it.
I care nothing about Klaus personally or what happens to me. I'm thinking about something more important.
For instance,
you're hoping for Alvin Sanders, and I'm hoping that Alvin Sanders does not want to be found. So, when you find him, it is quite possible that there will be trouble.
Right. Now, let's face a few facts, Lieutenant. You and your boss can help me. You're in charge of the Pontotomoc police force for all two men. And I imagine you've got a few other things in your mind besides the president of the state and the short term.
Look to me,
so that means I've got to do it on my own.
Anyway, Senor Dollar. This morning I attended the funeral of Benitez Santel, who was killed because he had information about Alvin Sanders. If you find Sanders and take the law into your own hands again, I fear I may have to attend another funeral. Yours.
That's what I like about Gomez. He was a kid. We walked down the beach about a mile below town. The beach kept narrowing as the jungle crowded closer and closer to the water.
Height of them from the beach away. If you go to pass, you can see the same thing. Walk right by it and never see it. Still.
And that's what we'll do.
Huh?
Walk right by it. And I want to lead anyone else.
There's nobody else on the beach.
I'm not talking about the beach. That's a regular jungle. A trillion people could be watching us. We'd never see them.
All right, just see.
We're going here, then we're going back. This is close. This is pretty quick.
Yeah. So, we're walking full of six flashlights. Looks like somebody's watching us. The glass can get pretty strong sometimes.
I think it's a little more of imagination.
What do you mean?
Listen.
Thank you.
Yeah. All these kings. Look. Keep moving straight ahead. I'm going to circle and see if I can intersect.
All right. Thank you.
Gloria, I'm going to circle to the right. Every few seconds, I'd stop and listen.
You nowhere.
Maybe not. Listen.
spot.
Yeah. Sounds like our shadow is somewhere outside. Keep talking, Gloria. Normal tone. I'm going out the back way and see if I can spot him.
Why don't you look around the hut, John?
Gloria kept up a line of patter when I stepped out the back door into the brush. Listen.
You want me to do anything?
Yeah, there's somewhere there. Clear. I worked my way around to the front of the cabin, still under cover. No sign. I jumped on around the other side. Then as I started to climb over a fallen tree trunk, I saw a shadow under the corner of my eye.
Hold it. Don't turn around.
The voice was behind me. I could see the rest of the shadow now. The hand of the gun. And I know it was zeroed in on my backbone.
I said hold it.
I'm holding.
Drop your gun.
Hey, look, whoever you are...
Don't turn around.
Okay.
And don't try to move.
I'm telling
you... Keep your eyes straight ahead. Any move at all, it'll be your last.
Final exciting episode in our story of the Alvin Summers matter tomorrow.
Yes, tomorrow, how to find out what you've been looking for the hard way. Join us, won't you? Yours truly, Johnny Dollar.
Johnny Dollar, starring Bob Bailey, is transcribed in Hollywood. Written by Robert Wright, it is produced and directed by Jack Johnstone. Be sure to join us tomorrow night, same time and station, for the next exciting episode of Yours Truly, Johnny Dollar. Roy Rowan speaking.
Texas Radio SW@gmail.com. That's Texas Radio SW@gmail.com. Goodbye.